Yeah, my name is Sylvain Gommier. I'm a product manager for this Puma phone. And this is the first ever Puma sport lifestyle device. This is the favorite menu, and on the back side what you immediately see is the solar panel. I'll tell you more about that in a second.
Sorry.
Do you need to do that again? So this is the favorites menu, and Puma being a sport lifestyle brand, you have sports on the left and you have lifestyle on the right. So it's a two-fold menu in this phone. All the settings in the phone are hidden under the carpet. This is what I promised you a minute ago. And even the boring stuff isn't so dull. For example, if you want to set the brightness, you just punch the cloud in and out, and that's the way Puma makes it fun for just even the boring settings. And you just flip the carpet back. If you go back to sports, you have the pedometer, which is counting your steps. So one of the sporty apps has this analog and clunky looking running machines in gym. If I come back to the bike tracker, this one is using GPS for more accuracy. So it's basically tracking your distance and speed and recording your route on the map so you can plot it later. You also have a compass, yeah, alarms, news feeds that are basically RSS feeds from your favorite teams, so you can get live news and live results. The stopwatch, again, it's Puma's way to do it analog. And it's all working like a real object would, but it's all in your pocket. And on the lifestyle side, you have all the basic stuff that you would expect from a phone. For example, the music player that is in effect on the turntable, and you can even scratch on it. So you probably can't listen to the sound right now, but it's very fun and very easy to use. So as I told you, the solar panel can get you energy from the sun. If I can find some hot space, you can see the little sun here light. But purple light is not so good. The fact is, when I have power energy inside, which I haven't at the moment, I'm afraid, you see a sun icon appear on top. And this is used for calls, for messages, and for music playback. So when you have a solar energy, that is basically free energy available, you can use them for calls, messages, and music playback. And for 1 hour under the sun, you get as much as 15 minutes of voice call, or 35 messages, or nearly 2 hours of music playback, just for 1 hour under the sun. So you see, it's not completely replacing a wall charger, but it's definitely a user benefit. And users can see this benefit clearly, because it's in application that they are using daily.
So if it's out in the sunlight, how long will it take to charge?
Direct sunlight? Under a very